Good morning. The St. Regis Parish Faith Community gathers for the liturgical celebration of the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We ask you to fully participate in the liturgy as a community by praying and singing together. The second collection is for the Maintenance Fund. There are four announcements. Today at 3 p.m., we will be having an organ recital here at St. Regis, featuring our associate organist, Kevin Litzinger. Everyone is invited to come and enjoy the special organ recital at 3 p.m. today. The parish picnic is on Sunday, August 25th, with Mass at noon, followed by the picnic at Monroeville Park West, Pavilion Number 2. The registration form is in the bulletin. Also, we ask that everyone take an invitation postcard found at the entrances of the church to invite friends, neighbors, and relatives to join us for the day. Bishop Mlesik has announced a day of prayer throughout the diocese for Wednesday, August 14th. It has been 1 year since the Pennsylvania grand jury report on clergy abuse was released to the public. This day of prayer is part of many efforts to try to help survivors, their families, and our parishioners get through this time of pain in the church. All parishes in the Diocese of Greensburg will be open from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. this Wednesday for private prayer with special intentions for those who have been abused and for the healing of the church. This week, we celebrate the Assumption of Mary into Heaven, a holy day of obligation. We will have two Masses for this holy day, Wednesday at 7 p.m. and Thursday at 7:30 a.m. To repeat, there will be two Masses to celebrate the holy day of obligation, the Assumption of Mary into Heaven, Wednesday, 7 p.m. and Thursday, 7:30 a.m.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. August 11th looks like Christmas. Look at all the wonderful people here this morning. We come together in our celebration of the Eucharist, and you may notice in the center section some mostly white, at least one green clad, member of our congregation today. We have with us members of the Greensboro Central Catholic boys soccer team, and I think some family members and staff as well. This is one of the things that the athletic teams at Greensboro Central Catholic do during the course of their year, is go to Mass collectively as a team. Catholic identity is important in our Catholic schools, and this is one of the ways that it is celebrated, so we're very happy. This is the first time I understand that any of the Greensboro Central Catholic teams have come to St. Regis, so boys, welcome, families, welcome, as we come together. Oh. As we come together in our celebration of the Eucharist, coming diverse as we are, coming to live our lives here as disciples, to celebrate our faith, to be strengthened and nourished in word and sacrament. And so as we prepare ourselves for this celebration of God's love, let us call to mind our sins, those times that we have failed to live as faithful disciples, and we ask our merciful God for pardon and peace. Lord Jesus, you are the Master whose return we await with eager longing. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the way that leads to the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you build us into a people longing to see your face. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth
peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, Lord God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The night of the Passover was known beforehand to our fathers, that, with sure knowledge of the oaths in which they put their faith, they might have courage. Your people awaited the salvation of the just and the destruction of their foes. For when you punished our adversaries, in this you glorified us, whom you had summoned. For in secret, the holy children of the good were offering sacrifice and putting into effect with one accord the divine institution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
flock of the Lord.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, faith is the realization of what is hoped for and evidence of things not seen. Because of it, the ancients were well attested. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. He went out, not knowing where he was to go. By faith, he sojourned in the promised land as in a foreign country, dwelling in tents with Isaac and Jacob, heirs of the same promise. For he was looking forward to the city with foundations, whose architect and maker is God. By faith, he received power to generate, even though he was past the normal age, and Sarah herself was sterile, for he thought that the one who had made the promise was trustworthy. So it was that there came forth from one man, himself as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and countless as the sands on the seashore. All these died in faith. They did not receive what had been promised, but saw it and greeted it from afar, and acknowledged themselves to be strangers and aliens on earth. For those who speak thus show that they are seeking a homeland. If they had been thinking of the land from which they had come, they would have had opportunity to return. But now they desire a better homeland, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was ready to offer his only son, of whom it is said, through Isaac descendants shall bear your name. As he reasoned that God was able to raise even from the dead, and he received Isaac back as a symbol. The word of the Lord.
when the Son of Man is coming. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not be afraid any longer, little flock, for your Father is pleased to give you the kingdom. Sell your belongings and give alms. Provide money bags for yourselves that do not wear out, an inexhaustible treasure in heaven that no thief can reach nor moth destroy. For where your treasure is, there also will your heart be. Gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from a wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant upon his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or third watch and find them prepared in this way, blessed are those servants. Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You must also be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." Then Peter said, "Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone?" And the Lord replied, "Who then is the faithful and prudent steward, whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I tell you, the master will put the servant in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants, to eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come on an unexpected day and at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will, but did not make preparations nor act in accord with his will, shall be beaten severely. The servant who was ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is frequently a spiritually perilous time of the year for many of us. We can get a little spiritually complacent and lazy. Easter is way behind us in our rearview mirror now. And despite the fact the Hallmark Channel puts on those stupid Christmas movies and takes off the Golden Girls, most of us are not thinking about Christmas yet. We're in that long stretch of ordinary time. These are the dog days of summer. We've all been in vacation mode, although I guess you guys are kind of out of summer vacation now. It's practice time. getting ready for the season. But we kind of slack off sometimes a little bit at this time of the year. We're worried about vacation and summer and everything that goes along with that. And sometimes we slip a little bit. You know, we think about all the progress. Hopefully we made progress during Lent and Easter. And sometimes we can kind of lose our edge a little bit. As we come now, summer's beginning to wind down. Practice is starting. School starts in a couple of weeks. We're getting ready to pass out of summer soon. Maybe what we hear today in our readings is a good primer for that, to help us to not become, or if we are, have become spiritually complacent, to get over that, to get ourselves back in a little better shape. Our readings today speak a lot about faith. You've heard me already say it since I've been here, that the Gospels oftentimes present us with both gift and challenge, and we get that again today. We hear a lot about the gift of faith, and faith is a gift, but is a challenge for us to live it out. We hear about Abraham. Whenever we hear about these great figures of Scripture, we think, boy, weren't those people something? Wasn't Abraham really something? Look at all he did. That's not the reason that we read about Abraham. Abraham was a man. Sarah was a woman, just like us, human beings. They weren't supernatural beings, flesh and blood. The letter to the Hebrews talks about the faith of Abraham when he was asked, and he was already about 75 years old, when God directed him to uproot himself, his family, all of his possessions, and take off from the land that he knew. Not giving him a destination, but God says, go, and I'll tell you where to go on the way. Now, most of us, by the time we're 75, are not looking forward to striking out in new adventures of life. But nevertheless, Abram, as he was then known, gathers up and goes as God calls. And he wanders in what will become the promised land for his descendants. And then, even later in the story, Abraham, who is well past the age of being a father, and Sarah, who is past childbearing age, plus the fact that she's infertile, God says, the two of you are going to have descendants as numerous as the stars of the sky or the sand on the seashore. And by this point, they're both at least in their 80s. I don't know how many 80-year-olds and over we have here today, but imagine being over 80 and you're going to have a baby. That's hard to believe. But in faith, they trust because the one who makes the promise is trustworthy. And then the child is born, Isaac. And God asks Abraham to do the unthinkable and sacrifice his own son. And again, Abraham trusts that all will be well because God is the one making the request. And again, Abraham's faith is rewarded. That's an amazing level of faith. But that's the life of faith that all believers are called to. Because the one who makes the promise, whether it's to Abraham and Sarah or to us today, the one who makes the promise is trustworthy. The one who has called us here, the one in whose name we are baptized, is trustworthy. And so we seek to live our lives as disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is our faith. In that gospel today, Jesus is throwing a lot of stuff out there at us, but there are a couple of things that stand out, at least to me. And maybe this is something that we can think about. This is a good examination of conscience as people of faith. Jesus tells his disciples, where your treasure is, there will your heart be. And so maybe that's a good examination of conscience for us today or any day. Where are our hearts? Where is my heart? Is my heart truly focused on God? Or has it slipped somewhere else? What is the focus, or who is the focus of my life? And if we don't like the answer, we can do something about it. The rest of that gospel, we hear Jesus, this is not a gospel, kind of gospel we're used to hearing in the summertime. We're used to hearing it, you know, in the fall, Jesus talking about being watchful and alert. And these gospels are not meant to scare us, but they serve as a reminder to us of the work that we have to do. Not to become spiritually complacent. You know, in the early church, there was a very strong belief that people in that time would see Jesus come back. They would still be living when Jesus would come back. That has not been the case. We know that it will happen one day. We don't think about that too much today. But whether it's Jesus coming back or whether it's us facing our own mortality, that will happen. And as we've heard in the news this past week, very tragically, sometimes it can happen very unexpectedly and very violently. And that's not meant to scare us. But that's meant to remind us of where we need to keep our focus in life. To be those good and faithful stewards that Jesus is talking about. A steward is one who is entrusted with gifts. And all of us are entrusted with gifts of time, of talent, of treasure, athletic ability, bank accounts, musical talent, or whatever. What do we do with those gifts? What do we do with the gift of faith? How are we using our gift of faith? How are we ministering to one another? How are we ministering as stewards of the Lord? In this parish, we have a lot of ministerial opportunities. Are we taking advantage of those? And are we doing our best at them? Or just going through the motions? We have a lot of ministerial opportunities that happen every day within our families, in our neighborhoods, with our neighbors, in our communities. And are we ministering to others as Christ? Or are we too busy with something else? We are stewards of the precious gift of faith. And we are heralds of Christ in the world. How seriously do we take that? With all the ugliness in the world today, are we being Christ to others? When we open Scripture, and hopefully we open Scripture and read it, are we reading it first as a Christian and then bringing the gospel to bear in the world? Or do we read the gospels through the red and blue lenses of Democrats and Republicans and then live the gospel like that? Are we partisans first and then Christians, or Christians first and partisans? How well are we using the gift of faith? How well are we stewards of the gift of faith? Where are our hearts? What is the status of our life of faith? As we come into our celebration of the Eucharist today, as we get ready for another change of seasons, as our soccer players are getting ready for a season, as we're gearing up for what lies ahead, as life in the parish gets busier, as summer winds down, let us take that measure of ourselves, that examination of conscience, very simple to do every day. Where is my heart? Is it focused where it needs to be, or has it slipped? What kind of steward am I? If I knew that tomorrow was the end of my life, would I live today any differently than I would otherwise? Are we being good and faithful stewards? The gifts that have been entrusted to us, may we make the most of what God has given us, and may our hearts truly lie in God.
Begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men, our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For us men, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate,
he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in the Lord, we have confidence to put into words our needs and those of our brothers and sisters.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, may we always prepare for the coming of the kingdom, committed to doing the work of the Lord until he comes again. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For those who serve us in government, at the national, state, and local levels, may God bless them with wisdom and courage as they govern those entrusted to their care. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For victims of gun violence throughout our land, especially in Dayton and in El Paso, may their families find consolation in God's love, and may those who were wounded recover quickly and completely. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For young men in our community, may they respond to the Lord with open hearts and willing spirits have called to the priesthood, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, marked with the sign of faith, especially Joseph Katakowski, whose funeral mass was yesterday, eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, may perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. Amen. During this Mass, we remember in a particular way Louise Chiappa and the living and deceased members of the St. Regis Parish family. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For the prayers we hold deep in our hearts, which we now pause to add.
O God, in whom we trust, you sent your Son as the fulfillment of your promise to the human race. You sent the Spirit to remain with us forever. Continue to bless us as we journey to our ultimate home in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please join in singing the presentation hymn, number 822, We Walk by Faith, number 822. Walk by faith and not by sight. No gracious words we hear from Christ who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near. We may not touch at hands and sigh, nor follow where he trod. Gracious words we hear from Christ who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Creator of the world and source of all life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, You always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the paths of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and saints, we too sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus took bread and said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, Saint Clare, Saint Francis, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Jesus has taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing the communion hymn, number 853, Be Not Afraid, number 853.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and
let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord. Again, very happy to have the members of the Greensburg Central Catholic boys soccer team with us today. How long have you guys been practicing now? Not practicing yet? Tomorrow? Oh, okay, tomorrow. Okay, well, I jumped the gun a little bit. When's the first game, first match? The counts? 3 weeks. Okay, well, happy practicing. Too bad you weren't practicing this weekend while it was cool. It's going to be hot again this week, so sweat it out. So hopefully you'll have a very successful season, a safe, enjoyable season, and more wins than losses. What's the season looking like this year? Going to be good? All right, we'll keep watching. So thank you guys for being with us, and have a good day. Again, a reminder that the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Holy Day of Obligation, is on Thursday. We have Mass Wednesday night at 7, Thursday morning at 7:30. And also, everybody's been asking me, Father, how was your vacation? My vacation was great. I got back at the end of the week, had a nice, relaxing road trip around the Great Lakes. And other than the stone that cracked my windshield, cost me another $100 on the rental car. The deductible. But other than that, it was a great week, and it's good to be back. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God. Please join in singing the closing hymn, number 904, Sing a New Song, number 904.
Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Singing alleluia. Shout with gladness, dance for joy. Oh, come before the Lord and play for God on glad tambourines, and let your trumpet sound. Sing a song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a song unto the Lord, singing alleluia. Rise, O children, from your sleep. Your Savior now has come. He has turned your sorrow to joy and filled your soul with song. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your soul be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Soul, for I have seen the glory of the Lord. The trumpet sounds, the dead shall be raised. I know my Savior lives. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your soul